went to the pet store the other day just to look around. I saw the cats and the bunnies, the birds and the snakes, and a hog that lives in the ground. But then I saw the cutest little puppy that anyone could ever see. I paid the shop owner, whose name was Elvis, and I took the puppy home with me. Well, I got him home and I fed him some bananas and I put him in some overalls. Then my little pet puppy did the strangest thing. He looked at me and said, meow. Well, my little doggy just said, meow. What do you think of that? Meow. My silly little puppy is so confused. He thinks that he's a cat. So I sat him down and I explained at length just what a little doggy should say, and that the other dogs would laugh if he said meow when he went outside to play. And he just sat there drooling with a smile on his face, sniffing at my shoe, pew. Then his nose turned up, he fell on his back and he looked at me and he said meow. Well, my little puppy just said moo and he wrinkled up his brow. My little puppy is kind of weird, he thinks that he's a cow. He's not a cow, what's he saying moo for? I said, you silly doggy, you don't say moo, but he just looked at me and ate some butter. So I said the other dogs would think he's weird and their laughter would be swift and utter. So I showed him how dogs say bark and woof. I showed him how they run and leap. But he just scratched his ear and he ate some bologna and he looked at me and he said, cheep. My little mongrel just said, cheep. Isn't that absurd? My silly little puppy is a little loopy, thinks that he's a bird. Hey, he's not a bird. So I gave up, I just quit trying to tell him what a doggy should say. He's my puppy, even though he's strange, and I love him anyway. Then he looked up from eating a corn dog, I think he shook his head. He licked me on the nose and he stood up on his feet, and this is what he said. He said, Mr. Heath, self-expression and learning are better fostered without conventional rules that bind creativity and reinforce complacency. Woof!